Hi everyone. I'm just going to go through a quick one here on how to scrape data from other websites. When I learned how to do this, it was so cool because you can just literally grab data from any website, and it's a really easy to use syntax as well. I'm going to be using this. I'm not even sure how you pronounce it, but this is a library. So you just install it using Composer. So I'm just going to write a quick command really that you just run, which we can use just to scrape anything off a website. So let's just install this first. So if you just paste that in your root directory of your project. While that's doing that, I'll just set up my so we just want to create, I'll open another window, just create a command. So what this is going to do is just create a command that we can run later in the terminal. So I'll show you where it puts it. So if you run that, so if you go in console and then commands and scrape command, and then just like then when I put a make command, this is the what you're going to type in for it to run. So I'm just going to put scraper colon start. You don't have to put a description, it's just for the list. So when you do you just do PHP artisan, the description is just this white text here. Hopefully that should have come up actually. Yeah, so our new command is already in there. So let's see if that's finished. Yeah. So if we copy these two at the top first. And literally just copy this. This is like a client. So you can set some defaults like timeout and things like that. But if you just leave everything as it is, it'll work. So, yeah. So this is what you want to do. Go to a website. So if we do, change list. It's been a while since I've done this, so hopefully this will work. We can just try that now, see if it errors or not. If we type out that command that we named it, scraper start. Actually, let's just use this. That's not ever this time, so it should have worked. So then what we want to do is, once you've gone to a page, we want to find, this is what usually the example that I use. So what this is going to do is it's going to look for all the H2 tags that have a link and go through each one and loop through each one, and then in the node it's going to print out the text. So we could just plonk this in actually for now and just see if it does anything. I'm not sure if there's any H2 tags on that site. Oh yeah, so this is these are all the H2 tags with links on that page. What we could do is we could look at the BBC site or something. So if we do... So what I want to do is look at these headlines. So I wonder if they've got a class that we can use to... Each of these boxes has a class. Hopefully they're all the same. I wonder if this one will work. So if we do... Let's just try this one. So you can just do dot and then your class name. Then it should output all the text within that div that's got that class. Let's have a look. Maybe that's not actually right. It's basically just looking through these items and seeing what is the same in each one, so you can loop through, right? I've never done it on the BBC site before, so we'll have to just it's a bit of trial and error. Let's just try and do it on an article page first. So let's see if we can pull in the full article using this one. Oh, I've just realized that I've still got this URL as not even BBC. That's why it's not working. Right, let's go back. See if it works now. Oh yeah, that's worked. So it's going through all those. It looks a bit messy because it's got the title and then it's got the description as well. But let's try and do the article now. So if we do... Let's do the Prince Philip article. So what you'd do is on the homepage, you'd do that and get all the links for the articles. And then for each one of those, you could run a separate job like this to go into each article and then pull out the text for the actual article. So if go on. Let's try this storyboard it in here, see if that works. Yeah, so this is all your all the text from that document. Oh, look. Some sites have things built in that stop you scraping it as well. And this looks like it's one of them. But you can get, So this has got all the different things that you can pull out from each element. So you can get... let's get... Yeah, so you can get like the URL of the links and there's so many different things you can get. You can pull in like the description from the meta tag and everything like that. I think I'll leave it at that for now and let you have a play with it, but I might come back to this and do a bit more in-depth one where I scrape a full website or something like that. I'll see you in the next video.